Welcome to the Shikama Live Show with your host, Shikama. Here's how I'm going to conduct this video and the rest of my videos. I'm going to give you some information, which is could be a video all by itself. And then towards the middle to end, I'm going to give you some news that probably will be devastating to a lot of you. So, I want you to watch the entire video. So, let's take a look here. So the video is entitled, Millennial Men Solidly Control Marriage Now. History. First of all, let's go over the history. Men were expected to get married when they became adult, quote-unquote. In America, that has gone from age 13 to 18, and then back to 16, still in some states. You will be considered an adult, able to consent to each and everything by yourself without parents' permission. Since women couldn't work, the husband had to win all of the money for the household. Women would not engage with men unless they were married to them. Since adulthood used to be 13, interest in men coincided with the marriage age. And when I say interest in men, I mean, you know, girls becoming now interested in boys. So it coincided with the marriage age because marriage age was so young back then, right? There was no need for adultery. Having a woman, not your wife, or a man, not your husband, wasn't a thing. Men aspired to achieve the most financial independence to marry the best, most beautiful woman. If he was really ambitious, he could marry into the money of his stepfather-to-be, right? Now, with the advent of women's total and complete independence, financially and socially and romantically, a woman no longer depends on men for so much of anything. With romantic freedom, women no longer need to save herself from marriage. The last thread of decency has come when romantic freedom has achieved chaotic stature, if you know what I mean. Now, women can approach men for a romantic session all by themselves. With women romantic freedom, men no longer have to sacrifice themselves to go through financial hardship to achieve financial independence, to be able to afford a home and be self-sustaining financially to afford a wife and family. Meaning he doesn't have to go to college, he doesn't have to become a professor, you know, he doesn't have to go through all of that. And in the meantime, taking out loans to achieve all of that, right? With the pill, the last wall to prevent complete romantic freedom disappeared. The final stage of romantic freedom came with removing the reputation loss of women who were romantically chaotic, if you know what I mean. A last vestige of the time when women were supposed to be married and upstanding citizens. With that gone, men could almost have as much chaotic encounters with women than ever before. Marriage. Marriage used to be the only way a man could engage in a romantic encounter with a woman, and both of them keep their reputation intact. Hanging with loose women could also jeopardize a man's earning potential. So if it was found out that he hung with loose women, nobody would really want them to be a part of their business, so they wouldn't hire them, right? Not so now. Now, a man can engage in the most chaotic romantic encounters as women will agree to it. Now, there are apps on the phone, and from the comfort of his bed, he can order a woman, no strings attached, no money changing hands, to his doorstep, and hence his bedroom. No waiting for marriage, no need to even have a job. Even homeless men can have romantic encounters with women of any standard. With that, the last wall crumbled around women's feet. There is no longer any incentive to get married. Chaos. Now, marriage is a very financial prospect for men, a very bad financial prospect for men. Not only is there no longer any incentive to get married, but now there's a whole list of reasons to avoid it like the plague. Where before a man was seen as the patriarch of the family, the rock upon which everyone in the family stood, now he loses reputation if he's married. It's complete chaos. But also, women now have lost their position as matriarch of the family, the intercessory to the patriarch, because his word was the last say-so in the house, and you would go to her to convince him to do something. Where before, if a couple was divorced, the children would go to the father, because he had all the money, and he would raise and take care of them, no question asked. But now, that has been reversed, and instead, the courts have decided to, instead, give the children to the mother, whom they thought was more caring for the children. Upon careful observation, even the courts have now found it was always the father that was more caring and capable of taking care of the children. Women have also grown more selfish, and kids are just an obstacle, and they are getting rid of them any way they can. Easy women. The final vestige of those holding out this idea that life is filled with romance has vanished with easy women. There is now 100 women who want to get married to 80 men who say they might. The other 20% of men literally have no intention of ever getting married. However, upon hearing the 20%, the researchers went back and asked the 80% again and found that even the 80% have no rush to get married, with it being open season on easy women. Romantically chaotic women, if you know what I mean, are now everywhere, and men have no desire to be married anytime soon. They estimate that in reality there will be 30% of men who will never, ever get married. That leaves 70 men for every 100 women to possibly get married. Because of this, the potential for a terrible man to get married who would not have ever gotten married before has almost 100% chance of getting married if he wants to. This means that horrible men will of course end up being divorced or worse, upping the stats for the divorce rate, right? Do you understand what I'm saying? Before, when it was 100 men to 100 women who wanted to get married, the men who were terrible men, period, possibly would never get married, right? Because the women could choose to go to any man, and she would choose the cream of the crop. Now, that goes on today still, but today, as the women take stock of their life and compare themselves to other women, they lower their standards and lower their standards and lower their standards to the point where you're getting criminals getting married. I'm laughing, but you understand, it's no joking matter. And so there's also terrible women, I'm sure, and this also means that women who should have never been married because they wouldn't make the grade for men who were actually in control of marriage to begin with, right? Were looking for women, right? They were looking for the cream of the crop too. That's what a lot of people leave that out, right? When a man goes courting a woman, he would look for the cream of the crop too. Nowadays, you have these women who shouldn't get married either, and they will be married to men who have zero standards and wind up divorcing those women too. Society. Ultimately, we all pay the price. We don't have stable married couples, which society is built on. We don't have stable couples, even. In fact, there's a revolving divorce door for about 20% of the married people. And this is where you get these stats that are blown out of proportion that says, marriage has a 50% failure rate. No, marriage doesn't have a 50% failure rate. Marriage has something like an 80% success rate, and then there's 20% that keeps getting divorced over and over and over and over. They even have a stat for that. They said if you've been divorced once, you have something like a 50% chance of getting divorced again. And if you've been divorced twice, you have something like a 70 to 80% chance of getting divorced. And if you've been divorced three times, you have something like a 200% chance of getting divorced. You just will not stick to it because You've been through the divorce rigmarole so many times, it doesn't mean anything to you. So, at any point, you could just declare you're going to get divorced. And these people who are on their first divorce, second divorce, third divorce, you know, it's not even their second marriage, it's their second and third divorce. This is how you refer to them. They comprise something like 20% of the married people, period, right? And they keep getting divorced over and over and over, and they keep counting them over and over and over. Fun fact, this is how they count black criminals, too. And it's something like 1% of the black population, but they keep counting them over and over and over, and then they blow out all of the stats out of proportion and say, oh, look, 50% of all these crimes. No, it's the same guy doing the same thing. And they keep releasing him. especially if they live in an all-black area. They release them more often than not. Versus if they're in an all-white area, they tend to keep them far longer than the white criminals. That's a fun fact for all of you all listening. This is why I keep trying to tell you all that the stats are wrong. The stats are wrong. At this stage, women are the enemy of men. Marriage is the enemy of men. And society, because the way it's been run and patronizing women, is the enemy of men. I'm just being objective. I'm telling you, know your enemy. Here's a conclusion. The only way to get out of this situation is that number, 80%, has to drop to 50% or 30% even. When it starts getting that low, society will have to reverse, because all of the grease and the oil that keeps the wheels of this bus going will dry up and the wheels will fall off. And once they fall off, it's all over. Here's a very good bit of wisdom. 80% of men need to say they will not get married and have no intention of ever getting married. Advertisers who run this entire mess will freak out and change society like yesterday. I'm telling you, if 80% of men said, I am not going to get married, I have not been married, and I have no intention of ever getting married. If 80% of the men, especially the millennials, they would reverse course completely. Do you know why? Because men can live in a studio apartment with one bed, one chair, a desk, console and TV, gaming console and a TV, if they so choose, or a PC and the internet. And that's how men can live and think nothing of it. There was a whole meme talking about it. This is how men live and they don't think anything of it. The reason we have mansions and castles and three-bedroom homes is for women. The reason we have Lamborghinis and Mercedes-Benz and Jaguars is for women. Men literally have gone to work and done this and that and the other to go up, 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 up to buy Jaguars and Mercedes-Benz and Cadillacs and SUVs and I can't think of cars and stuff, and boats and yachts and membership to the country club. Yes, it is to meet the other men in power, to have meetings with them, but all of that is to get money to impress a woman. Those days are over. Those days are over. They have so concentrated on women going to college and getting money, getting their own money, because women spend like they're drunken sailors or something like that. And they don't have to deal with men at all. They don't. This is why I said, society is your enemy, and women are your enemy. Know your enemy. And when I say enemy, I mean these are people who are opposed of you succeeding. I'm trying to give you information for you to succeed. Now, let me give you some stupendous news. I have a bad heart, you know, and I have high blood pressure. So I was going over information and doing research for this. Are you sitting down? All right. Each and every year, 115 million underaged boys, that is age 14 and younger. So we're talking about 14 years old, 13 years old, 12 years old, and maybe younger, are married off to older women each and every year. no one, and I mean absolutely no one, talks about it, and the government doesn't even care, doesn't want to do anything about it. When I went down the rabbit hole of finding that out, I was so overcome that I had to stop doing that research completely, and I just stopped. I cannot stand injustice. I can't stand somebody who actually is a victim being put into a victim position, especially if they cannot defend themselves. I believe a grown woman can defend herself. A grown woman can put herself into a situation where she never has to defend herself. That is wisdom. Don't put yourself into a bad position. But a child doesn't have that luxury. First of all, it doesn't have that mentality. And if we're talking about grown adults directing the ways of children, and more often than not, the parents are the ones who are doing this, it is not the child's capability to not put himself in harm's way like that. It is the adults around him who are controlling his moves and doing this. I don't know what to do. Write your congressman. I don't know what the answer to that is, but I want to make you aware of this. We already know that there's child brides, but now there's child grooms, and they're just now coming out with this information because nobody wants to talk about boys. Nobody wants to talk about men. Men are supposed to be super duper strong and Superman and blah, 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 and they can take all the insults. No, we're human, and I'm talking about children. 12 years old. I'm guessing the only answer is to write your congressman. I don't know what the answer to that is. Write your congressman. Do something other than sit on your butt and do absolutely nothing. I'm doing what I can, not trying to have a stroke, researching this stuff and putting this information out there. This is my platform. I'm putting the information out there. I'm hoping that you all will do something. Write your congressman. Keep hope alive, Rainbow Coalition, blah, blah, blah. Have a nice day. Thumbs up the video. Share the video. And if you can spare $10, buy me a Big Mac. Give me $10. There you go. Bye-bye.